Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope you are fine. I am also fine. Dear learners, today here for your English for today for the students of class 9 and I am your English teacher Shagufta Nasreen. So let's start our class. Welcome everyone, welcome to the class and here is my identity. I am Shagufta Nasreen, assistant teacher of Afanullah High School, and my contact number and email ID is on the screen. You can call me if you feel any problem or you can mail me. So dear learners, let's recognize these persons. You know who are they? I think I can help you. They are Shamsur Rahman, Jainul Abidin and Qazi Nazrul Islam. Among them, who is a painter? You know, the painter is the greatest artist of Bangladesh, is the painter Jainul Abidin. Learners, so our today's topic is, today we are going to discuss about Jainul Abidin, the great artist. It is in your Unit 7, Lesson 1. Now open your book, Unit 7, Lesson 1. See the learning outcome. After finishing this lesson, we can use some new words. We can talk about the biography of Jainul Abidin and describe the remarkable works of Jainul Abidin. Read and understand the text through silent reading and listen and audio, and answer the MCQs. Here is the keyword. So the word is here given on the screen, pioneer. You know pioneer, the picture is, you know who is she? She is Begum Rokeya, and on the screen we see Nari Jagoroner Agrodut Begum Rokeya. So Begum Rokeya is the pioneer. Pioneer, that means a person who take the first step to develop something new. And here is the sentence, Begum Rokeya is the pioneer of women's liberation in South Asia. It is a noun form. Next word, acclaimed. Word pronunciation is acclaimed, and we see the picture here. They make a clap, that means they praise someone, and someone get publicly praised or celebrated, that is acclaimed. So I think we can make a sentence by using this word acclaimed. The lady deserves acclaim for her charitable work, and it is a noun form. Next word, plight. Pronunciation of this word is plight, and we see a picture, a devastating situation. So what is plight? Plight is a situation that's difficult to get out of. And here is a sentence, the destruction of the building is man-made plight, and it is also a noun. Famine sketches, clear pronunciation, famine sketches, that is done by Jainul Abidin. Such famine sketches, that is world famous, drawing of a famine picture. And here is a sentence, Jainul Abidin was famous for drawing famine sketches. It is also noun form. And let us see some famous sketches that is sketched by Jainul Abidin. The sketches, the series of famine sketches you see here, and in our textbook we also have the famine sketches. Skeletal, pronunciation skeletal. This is a skeleton, and if anyone in such situation, that we can say that it, skeletal figure, frame or structure of body. द पिक्चर शोज द स्केलेटल पार्ट्स ऑफ ह्यूमन बॉडी. ओके लर्नर्स, लेट अस सी. इट इज एन एडजेक्टिव फॉर्म. सम स्केलेटल फिगर्स दैट इज स्केच्ड बाय जैनुल आबेदीन. सिनिस्टर, फियरफुल, हार्मफुल, इंजूरियस एंड pernicious. This is sinister. Timid people are afraid of sinister face. Sinister is an adjective. Depict, drawing of a painter that is depict in picture. And already the meaning is here, representing by drawing. Here is a sentence. A painter depicts his imagination by drawing pictures. Depict is a verb form. You know verb? Verb is an action word, and here in this sentence depict show the action word, so it is verb. Compassion. Compassion. See the picture. And already we have a feeling about it, compassion, that is sympathy or empathy. And we should have compassion for the helpless. It is a noun form, the name of a feeling, that's why it is a noun form. Charcoal. Charcoal is the material that Jainul Abidin used to sketch his paintings. This is charcoal, burning charcoal and cold charcoal. And charcoal, that means coal, cinder, burning object. And here is a sentence. Carbon monoxide is produced by burning charcoal. It is also a noun form. Famine, sorrowful situation of people of Bangladesh that they faced at that time, 1940. Famine, that means extreme scarcity of food. The inhabitants are totally ruined because of famine in this area. Famine, that means scarcity of food. It is also a noun form. And for famine, people have to starve. So the word is here starvation. Starvation, people have no food and they are suffering from various diseases. So suffering or death caused by hunger is starvation. Because of famine, people had to go through starvation. It is also a noun form. Learners, already we have discussed about the new words that is in our text, and now let us go through the text. And this time I will not read out, you have to read the text, and I will just express some places where you need. Dear learners, the pioneer of Bangladeshi modern art, Jainul Abedin, is widely acclaimed for his Bengali famine sketches. So Bangladeshi modern art is started by Jainul Abedin, and he was not only documented the harsh famine of 1940, but also shows its sinister face through the skeletal figure of the people destined to die, starvation, and in a man-made plight. So the famine that was took place in 1940, that was a man-made plight, and Jainul Abedin depict that situation through his sketches. And he produced a series of brush and ink drawings which later become iconic images of human sufferings. So Jainul Abedin, he developed a knack of drawing and painting when he was a high school student. And after completing his high school, he took admission in the Government School of Art, Kolkata, and then he graduated with the first position in first class in 1938. This is Jainul Abedin, and Jainul Abedin attended the Slade School of Art in London 1951 to 1952. Jainul Abedin is considered the founding father of Bangladeshi art. Everybody know him as the founding father of Bangladeshi art. He was an artist of outstanding talent and earned international reputation for his artistic and visionary quality. He is referred to as Shilpacharya and he is known as Shilpacharya Jainul Abedin. Shilpacharya meaning the great teacher of art. And he was the first principal of Bangladesh first art school in Dhaka in East Pakistan. This is Jainul Abedin. His achievement was the governor in All India Exhibition in 1938, and this is his achievement. And we see some more information about Jainul Abedin, what he produced him for his artistic activity. Jainul Abedin, he organized Nabanno exhibition in 1969 in exhibition 65 feet long scroll portraying the rural East Pakistan in phase from abundance to poverty. Jainul Abedin shows in exhibition symbolic of artist portrait and a milestone in demanding cultural and political freedom. He also made a scroll painting named Manpura. Jainul Abedin was done to commemorate the death of hundreds and thousands of people in Bangladesh. And also we can see that Jainul Abedin founded Folk Art Museum at Sonargaon and also Jainul Abedin Sangrahashala, gallery of own work in Moymansingh. And the river Brahmaputra has a great impact on the art of Jainul Abedin. So dear learners, let's enjoy a video of Sonargaon folk art.
Just outside of the city of Dhaka lies one of the most historic cities in Bangladesh, named Sonargaon. Folk arts and crafts museums exhibit wooden crafts, brass, bamboo, and metal crafts, painted work, musical instruments, pottery, textiles, ornaments, and much more. Folk Art and Craft Museum was established in Sonargaon in 1975, which has not only become a major attraction in the city, but also for the entire region. Other facilities at the museum complex include a crafts sales center. The museum is located on a picture square, 50 hectare piece of land that consists of breathtaking landscapes, peaceful artificial lakes and ponds. Once was only a dream for Shilpacharya Jainul Abedin, a legendary painter in Bangladesh, has become a complex filled with history, education and beauty, with its magnificent ancient buildings and monuments. It is only fitting that this wonderful capital will become home to a museum that captures and preserves the traditions and culture of the people of Bangladesh, and can be enjoyed by the entire family. Discover the Folk Art Museum and discover Bangladesh.
And we also see the Shilpacharya Jainul Abedin Sangrahashala. Let's see about Shilpacharya Jainul Abedin Sangrahashala.
Thank you.
This is Brahmaputra Nod, and Brahmaputra Nod, we see in the text that Zainul Abidin was inspired to be an artist by the river Brahmaputra. That means it is clear to us that Zainul Abidin was inspired by the river Brahmaputra very much to become an artist. And here is the pictures of Zainul Abidin Nabanno Utsav, the exhibition that was in 1969, and also Monpura, the picture that depicts how Bangladesh become from abundance to poverty. And some other pictures, these pictures has some special meaning. Can you guess? In picture 1, we see a very poor people who is sitting for, who is waiting for food. And in picture 2, we see two ladies are going for work. And in picture 3, the famine situation when man, dog, crow, every animal, birds, people, everyone suffer for the scarcity of food. In picture 4, riverside scenery. Picture 5, scenery of riverside also. Picture 6, two people are drawing ladder for cultivating crops. And picture 7 depicts the cart and two bullocks. Now let's hear a audio, and while you are listening the audio, in your textbook you have the MCQs, you will put a tick mark on the correct options. So let's start this audio.
On Tuesday, Dan Mozina, the US ambassador to Bangladesh, visited Shilpacharya Zainul Abidin Sangrahashala at Shahib Quarter Park area of Mymensingh town. There he spoke highly about the Bangladeshi master painter. The art gallery was established in 1975 to preserve the master painter's artworks in his own town. There are 62 artworks on different aspects of life and nature by Shilpacharya at the gallery. The art gallery also includes 53 memorabilia. The Deputy Commissioner of Mymensingh, the Police Superintendent and the Deputy Keeper of the Art Gallery were present during Mozina's one-hour visit. Commenting on the Art Gallery, Mozina said, "This museum is a global treasure. I am honored that my colleagues and I had this opportunity to experience the art of Zainul Abidin in his hometown. I am well acquainted with his work, especially the Famine series, as I visited several exhibitions of his works in Washington DC, where it was received with great acclaim." The US ambassador also said that Zainul Abidin was a true genius. His works are so simple, yet so complex and powerful at the same time.
So learners, are you ready to put a tick mark? Already we have here the question, and you have in your textbook, the US ambassador to Bangladesh considered Zainul Abidin what? A great painter. And number two, Zainul's art gallery was set up in 1975. The number of Zainul's artwork preserved in the gallery is 1662. And the US ambassador commented that the museum is a global treasure. And Mozina visited the gallery for 1 hour. So I think your answer and my answer is similar. And already we have discussed about the lesson of Jainul Abedin. Now, if you have the situation that you have to write the biography of Jainul Abedin, how can we do that? This is Jainul Abedin, and Jainul Abedin was born on 29th December 1914. Our sentence will be, the great artist Jainul Abedin was born on 29th December 1914. He was graduated from Kolkata Art School, and he was the first principal of art school in Dhaka. Next, his famous painting is Monpura. He achieved governor's gold medal, and Jainul Abedin died on 28 May 1976. Let us know something more about Jainul Abedin. Already we have known that he was born on 29th December, but he was born where? It was Kishorganj. He was graduated from Kolkata Art College when it was 1938, and he achieved first position in first class. He attended Slade School of Arts, London, during 1951 to 1952, and he was titled as Shilpacharya. The meaning of the word is the great teacher of art. This is all for Jainul Abedin, and dear learners, hope you enjoy the class and you have lots of information about Jainul Abedin. We will meet again on our next class. See you again. Thank you all.